Hello everyone, welcome to the next section where we'll be studying about if functions. Okay, in the previous couple of lectures we have covered the lookup functions, and I hope you have gone through all that. Now it's turn of a couple of if functions. Okay, I'll just share my screen. So this is the sheet where we will be discussing the if function. I'll just let you know what the sheet is all about. The sheet says these are the name of couple of people, and these are the ages, and these are their ages. And we know that if a particular person is having his or her age equals to or 18, he or she is an eligible voter. So we will be typing over here either he or she is an eligible voter or not. Before that, I'll discuss just in short about the syntax of if function. What if does? If we'll first test the criteria, okay? And if it's true, we'll print out that particular result. And if it's false, it will print out the other one, right? So we'll just learn with this example. Say for example, I have typed in over here. If you can see, it says it's logical test. So what's the test? The test is if this C2, if C2 is what, greater than or is equals to, because even if it is greater than is equals to, yes, he or she is an eligible voter. But if it is less than 18, if it is equals to 18, then also he or she is an eligible voter, right? So if C2 is greater than is equals to what? The number is 18. Value if true. If the value is true, what do you want to paste? What do we want this D2 to show? I want this to show as yes. If you have seen, I have put this yes into double quotation mark. This is for the string values. If you want to get any string value out of a function, you'll have to put that into a string into a double quotation mark, right? And value if false. If false, say for example, if this age is not equals to or greater than 18, what do you want to paste in the D2? So I want no, right? I want D2 to show as no, right? Let's just hit enter. Why no? Because the age is not greater than or is equals to 18, which is the reason why we have got this as no. Let's try this one more time, though we can drag and drop, but I just want to make sure that you have understood the if command, if function pretty well. I'll type in if, I'll go to the logical test, the if C3 is greater than is equals to 18, value if true. Like say for example, you want to paste it as eligible for voting. I'll just type in this, eligible for voting, right? I want to paste this. If not, if value is false, not eligible for voting. So you can, okay, what's the, okay, no colon. If C3, what was the function? Okay. So if C3 greater than is equals to 18, eligible for voting and not eligible for voting. Let me just do this, change a bit. Okay. Now, if I change this to 16, over here, it will come as not eligible for voting. So you can paste any text on the basis of a criteria. The criteria here was whether or not it is greater than is equals to 18, and on that basis you can apply the formula. If you want to drag and drop this formula, you can do that, and you can do this over here as well. If you want to change this, like I only want yes or no, I'll go over here and we'll change as yes or no. Okay, so this was if function with a single criteria. We will come across cases where we'll have different criteria. In that case, we'll be using nested ifs, which I'll be discussing in the next lecture. Okay, so practice the if function, and let's move on to the next lecture where we'll be studying about nested if. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.